This is a keyboard, obviously. And besides the moon here, what other symbol on the keyboard is the coolest looking? The dollar sign is very cool. Yes, that's true. But it's gotta be this one. This symbol that looks like a flowing wave is the tilde key. And this key will make your life editing so much easier, especially if you just started out in Final Cut Pro or you're switching over from another editing software like Adobe Premiere. I can hear some of you saying, I don't have that on my keyboard. And that is true. If you don't have a US keyboard, you may not have this key. Later though, I'll show you how to assign the actions that this key can do to whatever key you want, so stick around. Take this clip. It has some sound effects and voiceover audio attached to it, some B-roll and titles over top, and because Final Cut has the magnetic timeline, which is something other editing softwares don't have, if I try and delete just this clip on the primary storyline, you'll notice that it takes everything attached to it with it. That is the magnetic timeline at work, which is an awesome feature, mind you, and is incredibly useful, but not in instances like this.
But check this. Hold the tilde key and we get this really weird looking orange Pokeball thing. And then press delete. You'll notice that the attached clips are preserved. They stay positioned in the same spot on the timeline. But don't click off just yet because this key does more. Let's say you want to perform a slip edit. You press T to bring up the trim tool, so you can change the start and the end point of the clip. But when you scroll through the clip, everything goes with it. Tilde, scroll, and voila. Absolutely nothing moves, only the media in the clip. This key is also helpful when you want to move a clip in your timeline, but you want the connected media to stay in the same place. If I try and do that without the key, it is a no-go. With the key, you can take full control and override the magnetic timeline.
For those out there that don't see this key on their keyboard, here's how you can set it up to whatever button you want.
Press Option Command K. I already created a custom keyboard, but what you'll do if you haven't is press Duplicate, enter the name you'd like, maybe Custom, and search Override Connections. What you'll do is select this and then select that key that you like by hitting it on your keyboard. So let's say the equals key. And then press Reassign. I recommend not picking a key that's important though, otherwise you'll have to change that key to another key. Delete the default shortcut key and hit Save.
Like and subscribe if you enjoyed this video, and you may enjoy this short tutorial I did on a nice feature to help you eliminate jump cuts. Have a great day, guys.